Hi everyone, welcome y'all. Till our last video, we have seen like what is lambda expression and how to write lambda expressions in different ways. And also we have understood like what is functional interface and what are the different type of predefined functional interfaces we have in Java 8. So as part of the predefined interfaces, so we already discussed about what is the use of predefined functional interfaces. So by using predefined functional interfaces, we can write all lambda expressions as per day-to-day basis, and we can invoke our lambda expressions by using functional interfaces, predefined functional interfaces. So what are the interfaces we have discussed here is predefined functional interfaces. We can say predefined functional interfaces. So as part of this, we have four types of interfaces we have discussed. The first type of interface is predicate. So this is the particular interface we have earlier discussed. And the second one is we have function. So function is another predefined functional interface. And after that we also have consumer, and then last one we have is supplier. Okay, so these are four types of predefined functional interfaces which we have in Java 8. And by using these predefined functional interfaces, we can write lambda expressions, and also we can invoke the lambda expressions in Java 8. And all these predefined functional interfaces are available from Java 8 itself. So in the today's video, so we are going to mainly focus on function. So this is a predefined interface, predefined functional interface which we have in Java 8. So earlier we have discussed about predicate, and now I'm going to discuss about function functional interface. Okay. So when I say predicate functional interface, what we have understood on the predicate means the predicate is having one method called what is that method we have is a test method. So predicate is an interface which contains a method called test method, and which will take one argument as a parameter, and it will return a boolean. So this will return a boolean value. So when we need to go and use this particular predicate is if you have any conditional checks in your programming, then we can go and use this predicate along with the test method. So which will take any object as a argument or parameter which will return a single boolean value. Now when you come to the function functional interface, the function is also same like a test, but in the function we have one more method. As I said, each and every interface contains a single abstract method, then we can call it as a functional interface. So just like a predicate we have in a test method, similarly the function interface also we have one method which is called as apply. Okay, so this is a method which we have in the function interface. So in the case of predicate, we can pass any type as an argument, but finally we will get one boolean value. That's the reason we are going to use this as part of conditional checks. We are going to use this only for conditional checks. But sometimes when you pass some data to the lambda expression or function, we need to get some return value, not a boolean value. So in those cases, we can just go and use a function. So here we have a method called apply, and this particular method will take any type as a parameter. Any type of parameter we can pass, any object we can pass, and this will return a single value. It will return a single value of any type. This will return any single value of any type. So these are the two methods which we have. So test comes under predicate interface. Similarly, in the function interface also, we have a method called apply. So when you pass some type in this particular method, so which will return a single value, because it's a function, so which will return a single value, which can be any type. As per our requirement, we can define the parameter type as well as return type. So both will be there in the function. Okay. Now let us main discuss about the function. Let me just write how the function is created. Function interfaces comes under functional interface, predefined functional interface. So which is the prototype of this interface is like this. Interface, right? So function, interface function, which will take two arguments. One is the type, which is we can pass as an argument, and also we should have one return type. Okay, so in this function we have a method called apply. We have a method called apply which will take one type as an argument, and which will also return some type. It will also return the type. So here we have to specify the return type, and this is also public, and abstract method, because interfaces always contains the abstract method. This is only single abstract method which we have in the function interface. So function is a predefined functional interface and which contains a single abstract method which is called apply. And when we need to go for this one is, if you want to pass some type as an argument, then we want some value to be returned. So when I give something, we need to do some processing and then we will get some output out of this. So in that case, we can go and prefer to use function predefined interface to write a lambda expression. So in case of predicate, what we have done is we have just passed the input, we got only boolean expression. As boolean value we got as an output, because it doesn't return any other thing other than boolean. But here function will take argument type as well as return type also we have to specify, and then apply method will apply, and then it will do some process, and finally we return some value here. This will return some value. So this is a basic difference between predicate and function. And if you want to do some kind of conditional checks, we go for predicate. And if you want to do some operation, then we get the value, then we need to go for function interface. So in the predicate, we have a method called test, and here we have a method called apply. Now we'll see some practical examples how we can work with function interface and also how we can use this apply. So to work with we can write some different type of lambda expressions, and we'll try to invoke those lambda expressions by using this function interface, right? Now let's move on to the practical part. All right, so now we'll see how we can use function interface along with the apply method. So we already created one project called lambda expressions, and inside this I'm going to create a new package. I'll name it as functions. All right, so now let's say finish. So once you have created a new package, now let me just create a simple class and I'll say demo one. So first we'll see how we can use this function interface with small example. I'll say demo one, let's take a main method and then say finish. Okay, now what is the main purpose of function interfaces? So we can create a lambda expression. So when we need to go for function interfaces, you can pass some data or some value as a parameter, then it will return some output for us, or it returns some result for us. So let me just give you some basic example. Let me just create one function. And as I said, we need to pass two arguments. One is a parameter, second one is a return type. So both you have to specify here. So what type of parameter I'm going to pass is integer type. And what is an output I want to get is also integer type. Okay. Now here I'm just creating a reference variable. Let's say f equal to, I will pass one argument, that is n. And what this is a lambda expression. And then what this should return is, I'll say n into n. So this is a value which is written. So that means n square, which is written n square. So function which we have to import from java.util.function. So all the predefined interfaces are available in this package. Now, if I just look at this expression, so I'll say function, which will take two arguments, because one argument is representing the input type or parameter type. The second argument is representing the return type. So both we have to specify. Now f equal to, so the function interface is already having apply, which is abstract method. Just we have to use that method to call this in, to call the lambda expression. So f is a reference and equal to n. I'm just passing one argument and lambda expression. And what this will return is n into n, that means n squared. Okay, that is a return value. Now this is very simple and basic lambda expression which I have written. Now how we can invoke this lambda expression? So because it's a function type of interface, we have to use one method called apply. Okay, so in the case of predicate, we have a test method, but here we have one more method called apply. So how to call it? When I say f is a reference variable dot apply, then we have to pass one argument. So what is the argument? It is take integer type. Even return type is also integer. So let me just pass a value called 5. Then when I pass 5 here, what this will print is, the 5 will go as an argument or parameter. Then 5 into 5, 25 will be written. Now let us try to print this value. I'll say system.out.println. I just say f.apply. Similarly, I will also pass multiple values. Let us try to pass something called 10, and then let us pass something called 2. Okay, so I'm passing a different values, and this will take this argument as integer type and return the n into n, which is a square of the number. Now let us try to run this. So the first one is return 25, so that 5 into 5, 5 is a 25, and here 10 into 10, 100, which is written, and 2 into 2, 4 is written. So this is a basic example by which we can understand, like, we can pass a parameter, a single object or parameter, then which will do some action and perform and return some value. So whenever you want to get some result out of it, then we can go for function. And always remember, the function will take a two arguments. One is a type of parameter and the other one is a return type. So these things, again, we can configure. So what type of input you are passing depends on that. You can just change the type here. Similarly, what kind of return output you are getting depends on that. You can just specify the return type here. Okay, this is a basic example. Now I'll show you one more example. Let us say I want to find let's say string length. I'll pass one string and then I just want to get the length of a string. So same kind of lambda expression I'm going to write. So let me show you how we can write the lambda expression for this. I want to pass a string as an argument. When I pass string as an argument, let's say I'll pass string as a parameter, then it should find length of a string. And what is the type it will return? It will return integer type of output. So when I pass a string as an input, it will find the length of a string. Then I want to get a length of a string, which is in integer format. So let me just write a lambda expression for this by using function. So to do this, we again specify the function. And now here we have to specify the input type and return type. So what is the input type I'm giving? String. So I'll say string. And what is an output type I'm getting here is integer type. So I'll say integer type. Okay. And then a reference variable, let's say, give some name, let's say fn equal to, and we have to pass the argument variable. So let's say yes is an argument variable, and then lambda expression. So in the lambda expression, inside this function, what I have to do is we need to find length of a string. So whatever argument we are passing here, and s dot length. So I'm finding the length of a string, l-e-n-g-t-h. Length method I can use to find the length. So when I say s dot length, this will return the length, that is an integer type, right? So this is a simple lambda expression which we have written by using function. So we are passing one argument, string argument, and it is also doing length operation, and finally returning the integer type. So how to invoke this one? So to invoke this one, we need to use a reference variable fn dot, which method we have to call, which we need to call apply method, because the function interface contains the apply method. And here we have to pass a string argument. So let me just pass one string argument, and this will return the length, that is an integer type. So I can just print that value. I'll say system.out.println fn.apply, I'll say welcome. And similarly, let us try to pass a few more values. Welcome I have passed, and then here I'll say something Java programming, okay, something else. So let us try to execute it. Then we got two values. So here 7 is a length of a welcome, and Java programming length of this one is 16. Okay. So this is how we can just write some basic examples by using function interface. We can write some lambda expressions, and to invoke the lambda expression, we have to use apply method, which is available in the function interface. And remember, which will take two arguments. One is parameter type, the other one is return type. Okay, so I'll show you one more example. Suppose I want to pass some object as an argument, then I'll do some process inside this lambda function, then I'll return something out of it. Now let us see one more example. So this time I'm just creating, let's say demo2, new class, I'll say demo2. Let's take a main method and then say finish. So this time I'm going to pass an object as an argument. So let me just create one object here. So I'll create one object, let's say class employee. We need one class to create an object. So I'm just creating one class called employee. And in this, I'm just going to store a name of employee, ename, I'll say ename. Then I want to create one more variable called int salary. So to store salary, I'm just going to create one more variable called salary. Now to initiate the values into these two variables, I'll create one constructor as an employee, and ename is a string type of parameter, Then salary is a integer type of parameter. So I can use same names as a local variables also, right? Parameter names. In that case, we have to use this keyword to initiate. So this dot this particular e name equal to this particular parameter name. So whenever you want to use same names as class parameters and method parameters, an employee. So here this particular constructor should able to differentiate that which one is a class variable, which one is a method variable or constructor variable. For that we have to use this keyword. So this keyword is always representing the class name. So this dot e name equal to e name, and whatever value I'm getting into here as an argument, I'm assigning to the variable. Similarly, I'll say this dot salary equal to say salary. All right, so now I have initiated the values into these two variables and created one class. Now come to the actual main method. So here what I'm going to do is I just want to create one lambda expression. So what is my requirement here is, let me just tell you this. So my requirement is I'll create one lambda expression and I will pass a EMP object. I'll pass complete EMP object as an argument. And what this expression should do is, from this object, the expression will collect the salary value, and based upon certain condition, like if the salary is greater than or equal to or between 10,000 to 20,000, I want to increase the bonus, or I'll give some bonus for that employee. Let's say 10% of bonus I'll increase. Similarly, if the employee salary is between 20 to 30,000, then I'll give you 20% of the discount, so 20% of the bonus. So like this, I'll do some calculations in the lambda expression, and the bonus value I will return. So I will pass employee object. When I pass one employee object as an argument, our lambda expression internally will find out the bonus based upon the salaries of the employee. Accordingly, it will also return the bonus. It will calculate the bonus and it will return the bonus. So this is my requirement. So what is the parameter I'm passing as an EMP object I'm passing as an argument? And what is the return type here? Return type is integer, because which will return the only bonus value. So the return type is integer. Now let us try to implement this. Now what I'll do is, I created already employee class, and then I'll create multiple employee objects. I'll take one array with array list, and in array list I will store multiple employee objects, and for each employee object I need to find out the bonus, okay, based upon certain calculation. So now I'll create first of all, let me just take one array list which contains a multiple EMP objects. Now I'll apply the function on each and every object, which will find the bonus of the employee. So let me just create one array list, okay, and I'll say EMP list, and what it contains, EMP objects. So what is the type of this array list is employee type, okay, because what kind of objects we are storing into this array list, we have to specify the type of object. So all objects are employee type. So I say employee. So equal to a new array list. And here also we have to say employee, and then close it, right? So now import this array list from java.util. So now I created one array list, which contains, it allows us to store only employee class objects, right? Now I'm going to store multiple objects into this array list. So how we can create objects? I'm not going to use any reference variables. I'm directly going to create an object and put them into array list. So I'm taking this one, EMP list dot. So I'm adding one object into this list. So how to add? New employee. This is the first object I'm adding. But whenever you're creating an object, the constructor will invoke, assign the data into these variables, right? So when I calling the when I creating the object, we should also pass the data. So the first value I'm passing is name of the employee, and the second parameter is a salary of the employee. So I'll say 50,000. This is the first element I have added to the array list, first object, first employee object. Similarly, let us try to add a few more list. Let's say I'm going to add three different employees. I'll say David, I'll say John, then I'll say Mary, and he's 50,000, and he's 30,000, I'll say 20,000. Right, so now I created EMP list, and which contains three employee objects. Now what are my requirement is, I want to read each and every object, and I will pass that object to the lambda expression function, and then which will calculate the bonus of the employee according to the salary, and which will return the bonus of that particular employee. So I want to calculate bonus of all the employee objects. All right, so that's my requirement. So let me just write one function. So how to write a lambda expression using function? So that we have to first write. So let me write one function. And what is the input type? What is the argument type? And what is the return type here is? We have to pass emp object, right? Emp object, employee object. So the argument type is employee, because we are going to pass. So we need to remember this. So this is our lambda expression. Then what you have to pass here is emp object. We have to pass emp object. We have to pass, and the object is employee type. And what is the return type? The return value is a bonus, which is integer type, which is integer type. So we have to remember this. So the argument type is employee type, and what is the return value is integer, because which will return the bonus of the employee, right? Now I'm creating I'll say f1 or function equal to, right? So I'm passing the object parameter. So let's take one variable e, which is argument lambda expression. Now in the lambda expression, if you have a multiple lines, we should include in the curly braces. If I have a single statement, directly I can write it here. But if you have a multiple statements, we have to include in the curly braces. So I'm writing curly braces here. So here, this is a starting brace and ending brace. And here also we have to put the semicolon. Now here we have to do some calculation, and we have to capture the employee salary from this object. Then we need to do some bonus calculation. And finally, we have to return the bonus based on the salary. We have to calculate the bonus value, and then we will return that value. So what I will do is, based on certain conditions here, I will calculate the bonus of the employee. So let us assume here I'm passing the employee object, right? I'm passing the employee object. From that employee object, I'll extract the salary and I store that in a variable. Let me just create one internal variable called int sal equal to e dot salary. Okay, so I just created one integer variable to store the salary, and I'm getting the salary value from this object. Now I need to check multiple conditions here. So by using if else condition. So first condition I'm verifying, if sal value, if the salary value greater than or equal to 10,000, and if it is fall between 10,000 and 20,000. So if sal greater than or equal to 10,000 and sal less than or equal to 20,000, sal less than or equal to 20,000, then what I have to do, I should return salary. This is the formula I'm using, salary into 10 divided by 100. So 10% of the salary I'm giving as a bonus. So this is the value I'm going to return if this condition is matched. Else if, suppose I'm putting one more condition, else if, and I'll put one more condition, else if, I'll say salary greater than 10,000, greater than 20,000, because already less than or equal to 20,000 we verified. Greater than 20,000, less than or equal to 30,000. If the employee salary is between these two, then what I have to return, I'll give you 20% of the bonus. So the same formula I'm using here, I'll say instead of 10, 21% of the bonus I'm increasing. Similarly, I will put one more thing. Okay, so else if salary is greater than 30,000, less than or equal to 40,000, or less than or equal to 50,000, then I'll increase the bonus of 30%. And even it is not fall under, then other than these, suppose if the salary is less than 10,000 or salary is greater than 50,000, in all other cases, I will just put one more condition and say return salary. I'll give 10, 20, 30%. We already given. So 40% discount I'm just giving. 40% of the bonus I'm giving. So this is based on certain condition, I'm calculated the bonus, and I'm returning the bonus value. So at a time, only one condition will be matched. So I'm getting the salary value from this object beginning itself, and based on the salary, I'm verifying or calculating the bonus. And finally, this particular lambda expression will return the bonus of the employee. So this is how we need to first write the lambda expression. Now import this function from java.util.function. Then this is a lambda expression which we have written. Okay, because we have a multiple statements, I kept inside the curly braces. Okay, so this is a lambda expression which I have written by using function predefined functional interface. Okay, now what I will do is, what is the main purpose of creating this lambda expression? I just want to find the, I want to calculate the bonus of every employee object. So we already created multiple employee objects here. So now I will pass each and every object into this lambda function or expression, then I will get the bonus of the employee. Okay, that's the main purpose of creating this lambda expression, right? So now I will read each and every object from this EMP list. I will pass that object into this lambda expression, which will return the bonus of that particular employee object. Now for that, what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to write one enhanced for loop. Observe this carefully. So I'm writing one enhanced for loop. In this, I'm just going to specify the EMP list. From this array list, I want to get each and every EMP object, right? Let me just say EMP. And what's the type of this variable? Employee. Because if I create an employee variable only, this will be able to hold the object from the employee list, because this is the type of employee, and this variable also should be same type, employee type. Now from the EMP list, first it will get the first object and store that into this EMP, right? Then from this EMP, what I should do is, EMP is an object. So I will pass this object into this lambda expression, then it will process it, and finally it will return the bonus of that particular EMP object. Okay, that is our expectation. So now internally, I will just call this lambda expression. How to invoke the lambda expression? In the function, we have a method called apply. So we have to call that method. So fn is a reference variable I'm using, dot apply, and we are passing EMP object, simple. So when I pass this EMP object to this lambda expression function, then this will return the bonus of the employee. So from this object, it will get the salary and it will calculate the bonus, and finally it will return the bonus. So to print the bonus, to store this bonus, I can create one variable called int. I'll say bonus, then I'll print that value here. System.out.println. Okay, so system.out.println. So first I will print EMP, what are the details we have added? Ename and salary only, right? So ename and salary first I will print. So from this same EMP, I'm just trying to print ename, and I'm giving some space. Then I'm going to print salary. So EMP name and salary I'm printing, but these two values I'm getting from the object itself. But bonus, I got it from the lambda expression, right? So by calling the apply method, which will go here, employee object, bonus is calculated, then returns the bonus. So this will also, I will print here, especially I'm printing system.out.println, and here I'm just printing bonus is. After printing the employee name and salary, here I'm printing bonus is, and double quotations plus this variable. That's it, guys. So this particular for loop, right? I'm reading each and every employee object in this variable. I'm passing that object into the lambda expression by calling apply method. And this expression or function is returning the value, which is again integer value, that is a bonus. Store them into this variable. And along with the employee name and salary, I'm also printing the calculated bonus, which is written by this lambda expression. Okay, now let us try to execute this Java application. Now we can see we got the value. So David is a David, 50,000 is salary, which bonus is this one. And John, which is a 30,000 is the salary, and bonus is 6,000. Mary, 20,000 is the salary, bonus is 2,000. Okay, so this is how we can just write a lambda expression by using a function, which we can invoke by using apply method. Now we have understood how to use this function to create a lambda expression and how we can invoke the lambda expression. Now here, what I will do is I will also try to include predicate. So in the previous session, we have seen how to use predicate. So what is a predicate means? Which will take a single parameter, which will return a Boolean value, right? So what I want to do is here, I'll try to use something called predicate. So why I'm using predicate is, so once you get the bonus here, I'm directly printing the bonus. But what I want to do is, once you get the bonus, if the bonus value is greater than 5,000, if the bonus value is greater than 5,000, then only I want to print the details of the employee. So currently what I'm doing, I'm just calculating the bonus by calling this lambda expression by apply method. And once you get the bonus, I'm just trying to print employee data along with the bonus. All the details I'm printing. But here I'll try to apply one condition. What is that? Whatever bonus it is calculated, if this particular bonus value is greater than 5,000, then only I want to print the employee details. So if we have any conditional checks in your program, so what will be preferred? Predicate, right? So apart from this functional lambda expression, I will also write one more lambda expression here, and which will write by using predicate, right? So I'll write one predicate. So predicate means it will take only the one parameter argument, which will return a Boolean value. So in this predicate, what I will do is I will pass this bonus value. Then it will calculate whether it's greater than 5,000 or not. If it is greater than 5,000, then returns true. And based upon the return type, I will display the data here. So I'll create one predicate and which will take one parameter, which is integer, and create one reference variable equal to, and I'm passing some object here. Let's say this particular bonus, whatever I calculated, I will pass this bonus value to this predicate. So let's say B is my argument, and internally I'll say B greater than 5,000, and import this predicate from java.util.function. So this is a predicate lambda expression I have written. So what exactly which will do is, which will take one integer argument and which will verify which is greater than 5,000 or not. If it is greater than 5,000, which will return true. If it is not greater than 5,000, which will return false. Okay. So now I got the bonus here from the function lambda expression. Now immediately I will pass this bonus to this predicate lambda expression. Okay. So how to pass it? I need to just call this predicate by using which method? We have to use test method, because in the function we have a apply method, right? Similarly, in the predicate we have discussed about test method. So we have to use that method. So we have to use this reference variable called B. Okay. P is my reference variable dot. I'm using a test method because the predicate contains a test method. And then I'm passing this bonus here. So observe this. This is calculated by using function. Okay. But this we have done using predicate. Both have included one example. So by using this reference variable, I'm just passing the bonus value, which will test whether it is greater than 5,000 or not. If it is greater than 5,000, which will return either true or false. So I'm put this in the if condition now. If it is returning true, then I will print these three values. Employee, salary, and bonus. Okay. When this will print the values, if the bonus is greater than 5,000, then only it will print. So to calculate the bonus, I'm using this lambda expression, which is created by function. And to check the bonus is greater than the 5,000 or not, I created one predicate lambda expression, and I'm invoking this internally in the for loop. Okay. So this is a combination, function and a predicate, because function will take argument and return the result. Whereas in the predicate, it will take the argument, but returns a Boolean value always. So here I'm getting the Boolean value. If it is a true, print the details of employee, or not, don't print the details of employee. So I'm filtering the data here. So let me just run as a Java application. Now you can observe this. David's salary is 50,000. Bonus is, I'm checking condition. Bonus should be greater than 5,000. So for the only these two people, the bonus is greater than 5,000. Here 15,000, which is greater than 5,000.
here, which is 6,000, which is also greater than 5,000. So it is exactly printing the value. Okay, so this is how we can use function and predicate the combination in one program, right? Now, in the functions, in case of predicate, we have seen how to join multiple predicates, right? Similarly, in the function also, we can join it. In the function also, we can join, or we can chain the functions, multiple functions we can combine, right? So now I'll show you one more example, how to chain the functions, or how can achieve the function chaining or combining the functions. Let me just give you one example here. Okay, so the one example here is to combine these two functions, we have actually we have one method. So let me just write it. So here, to combine, or we can chain the functions. So to chain the functions, we have two methods are available. Let me write this. For chaining the functions, we have two methods are available. The first one is and then. This is one method which is available. The other one is a compose. Compose is one more method which is available. So by using these two methods, we can achieve the function chaining. We can achieve the function chaining. Now, let me just give you one example how we can use these two. So what is the basic difference between and then and compose? So let's directly see the practical example. So let me just go to one class. I'll say demo 3. Take this main method and say finish. All right, so here I'll just show you the basic difference between those two methods while function chaining concept. Okay, so now let's see what is the difference between and then and compose. So for that, I will create two function lambda expressions. Okay, so first I will say function, and as I said, function will take one parameter and return the value. So let me just take one integer argument I will pass. I'll pass one integer argument. Also, the return type is also integer. So let me import this function. Okay, later I will do that. So function, I'm passing integer argument. I'm getting the return type is also integer. So give some reference variable f1 equal to. And how to implement this? I'll say the parameter lambda expression. And then I'll double the value. So I'll say n*2, which will double the value. So import this function from java.util.function. Integer comma integer is a argument, and this is a return type. Reference variable equal to n is an argument, and it will also return the value. So n is an argument, n into 2 means double value which will return, right? So similarly, I will also write one more function lambda expression. So here I'll say f2. And here also I'm passing n value, but it will perform the cube. Let's say n into n. Okay, so now I have created two function lambda expressions. Now let us try to call them. Just hold on. All right, so now I created two lambda functions and two lambda expressions using functions. So now let us see the difference between and then and compose. So first let me use and then. So how we can use it is, I'm just calling this f1. Okay, so f1, and using one method called and then, and then say f2, and then I'm calling apply method, and I will pass some value called 2. Okay, now observe this expression, and as I said, this one lambda expression will return some value, right? So the returned value, I'm printing it here. I'll say system.out.println. I'm just printing this value like this. Now let's try to understand this. So what exactly f1 and then f2 will happen is, first one, when I pass apply 2, this value will first go to f1. Okay, first it will go to f1, and whatever result it will return, the result again will pass it into f2. The result again will pass it into x1. First f1 will execute, the 2 will be passed into f1. So it will do some calculation and it will return the result. The same result again will pass it to f2. Okay, then f2 function, whatever result we will get from the f2, that will be printed. So this is a actual process of and then. Now first f1 will execute, the returned output again will pass it into f2. So accordingly, if I just calculate how much value we have to expect here is, first 2 will be go to f1, So what is the output we will get from F1? 2 into 2, 2 to the 4 we will get. Now again, this value will again go to F2. So what F2 will go to? F2 will receive the 4 and 4 into 4. So which will return 4 into 4, totally 64 should return. The outcome of this statement is 64. Now let us try to run it, which will give 64. This is a exact function chaining. So when I say end, then first F1 will execute, and whatever result we will get, the same result again will pass it to F2, and then final output or final result it will print here. So this is a about end then function. Now the same thing I will write by using compose. Instead of end then, I'll say compose. Then how the compose is going to do? So compose means first it will execute F2, and then returned output will be again sent to F1. So this is a reverse order. The basic difference, guys. So in the end then method, first it will execute F1, then it will go to F2. But in the compose, first it will execute F2, then execute F1. So reverse order it will execute. All right, so now we'll see how it's going to execute. In this case, we got the 64 output. Now in this case, what is the output we are expecting? First, it will call F2 method. So 2 will be passed to F2. What this will return? 2 into 2. 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8. Okay, so which is first F2 function will return 8. F2 function will return 8. 2 into 2. Okay, and the 8 again sent to F1. 8 again will send to F1. So what F1 will do? 8 into 2. 8 into 8 means 16. So which will return 16. Okay, which will return 16. Because 8 into 2, 2 8s are 16 is the output. Okay, so this is how we will use end then and compose. Let's try to execute and see the output. The first one is return 64 as per our expectation. And the second one is return 16. So by using these two methods, end then and compose, we can chain the functions. We can execute the F1 first and then F2, or we can execute first F2 then F1. So then and compose will execute in the reverse order. Okay, so this is a basic difference between end then and compose. By using these two methods, we can achieve function chaining in the function interface concept. Okay, so with this we have understood how to create a lambda expressions by using functional interface, and how to invoke the lambda expression by using apply method. So far we have discussed about predicate and function, right? So what are the differences we have observed? In the predicate interface, we have to pass one argument. It can be any type, only one single type we have to pass, and the return type is a boolean. And what is the method we use here is test method we have called. Now in the function, what are the types we have to pass? Input type we have to pass. Here we will have only input type, or we can say parameter type. When I pass single parameter type, and then it will return the boolean. But here we have to pass parameter type, also the return type also we have to pass. And finally, what this will return? It will also return some output will be written. That can be again based upon your requirement type. Sometimes it will return integer or double or string, whatever it is. Okay, so in the predicate, we have to pass one parameter and we'll get the boolean. In a function, we have to pass parameter along with the return type, then it will return some return value. And in the function, what's the method we have? In the function, we have apply method. And when we need to go for predicate, if you have any conditional checks in your program, then we need to go for predicate. When we need to go for function, if you want to process something and get the result, then you need to go for function, because predicate test method cannot return the result. It can just return the boolean. But if you want to get the real value or return value, then you can go for the function. So these are the basic differences between predicate and function interfaces. Both are predefined interfaces, and which we can use it for writing lambda expressions, and we can also invoke the lambda expressions. Okay, so that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching.